A determination of incompetency will prohibit you from purchasing, possessing, receiving, or transporting a firearm or ammunition. If you knowingly violate any of these prohibitions, you may be fined, imprisoned, or both pursuant to the Brady Handgun Violence Protection Act or Prevention Act.
So here you are, you served your nation in Vietnam, multiple tours, you've lived a great life. Have you been convicted of any big crimes in your life?
I've never been convicted of any felonies. God, years ago, I get a ticket.
So you've had a ticket in your life, and now not only because you went to the VA for more help to try to manage the problems that are born from his service in Vietnam.
Right.
And now they're telling you that you would be imprisoned. It, not only they want to take your gun right away, but that if you violated that, you would then become a criminal. I mean, how did it make you feel to hear about this?
Man, I was angry. And there for about a week after this came, why? Well, she can tell you, I wasn't very, well, I don't know what you call it, communicative. I was just so angry. Hard time sleeping. It just wouldn't go away. I was just ticked off.
Right.
You know, I don't know what else to say about this. It was almost as if I kept thinking, oh God, this country is starting to turn more and more communistic. That's what I was looking at. You know, the senators, the presidents we've had in office taking this nation down.
Did you ever imagine having your right to bear arms?
No, never.
Taken away.
You know, I could understand it if you were a felon and you were put in prison as a result of, well, who knows, shooting, killing
for
somebody.
Any crime.
You're right. To lose your firearms, okay. But this, what they're trying to do here, to me, is communistic. And I hate to say that, but this government is taking away our rights. Not just the Second Amendment rights. Fifth Amendment, you know.
Sue, you mentioned that in the first.
The 14th Amendment. Where's his due process, and what gives the Department of Veterans Affairs the right to judge him incompetent and take away his firearms? Who gives him that right? Anybody else who's not a veteran gets their day in court by a judge, by a jury of their peers to judge them incompetent. We know how that works. Where's his right? Where's his right to, you know, defense? Where, you know,
Right, and you told me from the beginning that you have a plan in place so that because you handle the finances,
right,
just because that's how
right
it happens to be in this family, but you have a contingency so that your daughter and son-in-law
right, yes,
would just
yes.
So there was never really an issue with the
no
finances in this family.
No, there never has been. He's got, it could be better, but he's in the mid 700s in his credit rating.
Right.
You know,
and did you tell me earlier, Pat, I mean, if you needed to do your finances?
I could do it. I can add and subtract.
You'd have to go back the old paper way because
certainly
you can't do it on the computer.
Never.
Taken away.
You know, I could understand it if you were a felon and you were put in prison as a result of, well, who knows, shooting, killing
for
somebody.
Any crime.
Any, any, any,